Good morning, my name is Nick Masterson. I'm the Central Regional Manager for SPX Flow Technologies out of Delavan, Wisconsin. We're here at WEFTEC 2013 today, demonstrating a variety of liquid handling devices. I'm responsible for the pumps out of that location. Four different brands, Bran+Luebbe chemical metering pumps, Waukesha Cherry-Burrell rotary positive displacement pumps, Johnson centrifugal and gear pumps, and plenty screw and vane pumps. Touch briefly on the different applications for all. There are a variety of liquid handling applications in water and wastewater treatment. We'll start with the Bran+Luebbe's. These are sealless diaphragm metering pumps, very accurate, typically used for chemical dosing, pH adjustment. So it'll be sulfuric acid, caustic, could be ferric chloride, anything that's going to neutralize the water before you return it to the stream. Waukesha Cherry-Burrell products are rotary positive displacement pumps, again, very accurate. These are typically used for higher viscosity liquids, things like polymers or flocculating agents to take the fine particulate out of the waste stream once it's been through the main filtration. Very, very low shear, so you don't break the polymer chain. Very important in that kind of an application. And then for Johnson pumps, today we feature our self-priming centrifugal pump. These are used for relatively clean liquids with small particulate in it, and especially if they have entrained gases. The way these pumps work, they will separate out the gases from the liquid so that you pump the gases out of the stream altogether. Why they're self-priming is they have a lower pumping chamber. We'll get into the details a little bit later on. They keep the pump primed once it's got liquid in it, so you don't have to keep priming it every time you start the pump up. The products are made in different locations throughout the world. We do assemble and manufacture some of them. The Waukesha products are manufactured in Delavan, Wisconsin. This is an American-made product. The Johnson pumps are out of Sweden, and they are made primarily there with some parts out of India. The Bran+Luebbe designs and manufacturing is all done out of Norderstedt. Today we'll talk about some of the more specific applications in water and wastewater treatment and how these pumps operate in a given application. We'll start with the Johnson centrifugal pump. In this case, this is a self-priming centrifugal. It's ideal for handling light liquids, waters that have some particulate in it or some entrained gases or air. Instead of, as opposed to a standard end suction centrifugal where the inlet comes straight into the face of the impeller, the impeller is dropped down below the inlet of the pump, creating a sump or an area for the liquid to retain after it's been primed. As the liquid comes in, there are volutes cast inside the body that separate out the gases from the liquid. So what you end up with is an air-free liquid in a chamber directly in front of the impeller. And as the pump operates, the gases are slung out to the sides of the body and then discharged out the pump. If you shut the pump down and go to start it up again, you now have air-free liquid in this pumping chamber. The pump primes itself. You don't have the difficulties of cavitation trying to prime an end suction centrifugal with entrained gases in the liquids. We have an oil bath that separates the pumping chamber from the bearing block back so that you won't get contaminated water or contaminated liquids into the bearings, causing corrosion and damage. Next application is chemical dosing into the waste stream after all the filtration has been accomplished. It has to be pH neutralized and any other chemical contaminants removed before it can be returned to the stream. In this case, you use a chemical metering pump, which is typically very, very accurate, and it has to be sealless because you're going to be pumping things like sulfuric acid, caustic, sodium hypochlorite, ferric chloride. You don't want fugitive emissions, you don't want leaks, you don't want environmental contamination. So in this case, what we'll use is either a mechanically actuated diaphragm or in this case a hydraulically actuated diaphragm pump. It's a reciprocating piston that flexes a set of Teflon diaphragms. This is the pumping chamber. It is hermetically sealed. So you've got a static seal clamp area around the diaphragm and then gaskets at either end of the suction and discharge check valves. As the piston reciprocates, it flexes the diaphragm, fills the pumping chamber. On its discharge stroke, it pushes the liquid out the discharge side. They're all gauge or switch monitored. There are two Teflon diaphragms with a vacuum that's pulled between them. If either one of them senses pressure, the gauge will start, or you can set an alarm and you can determine the health or the condition of the diaphragms and take the appropriate measures should something go wrong before you see contamination to the environment. This is a hydraulic pumping chamber that moves liquid back and forth. You've got an internal safety relief valve to prevent overpressure damage. And all of these pumps feature what we call an open yoke architecture. There's a positive separation between the pump fluid and the gearbox that drives the piston. So should you get past everything, the worst case scenario, you would leak out into this area here and you would capture in a pan below. So you can't cross-contaminate between the pump liquid and the gear itself. Infinitely adjustable from 0 to 100%. Accuracies to plus or minus 0.5%, which is very critical in pH neutralization if you're using it for potable water, drinking water. Let's say you're pumping fluosilicic acid for fluoridating the water. You have to have that to within very, very tight parts per million. This pump will help you accomplish that task. In all applications, once you finish filtration and screening, you're left with liquid that has fine particulates. And the fine particulate has to be removed. The best way to do that is to introduce a flocculating agent, basically a chemical that binds the fine particles to it that can be removed. Typically, you're using a polymer, and polymers tend to be very shear sensitive. And if you impart energy into them, you'll break the chains down and you will destroy their ability to flocculate small particulate out of the liquids. So to prevent that, you can use a rotary positive displacement pump like the one that's made by Waukesha Cherry-Burrell. In this case, we use a bi-wing rotor that is set to a set of timing gears in the back that keep these set 90 degrees from one another. You've got very tight tolerances between the wings and the body so that it is a true positive displacement pump. There's very little slip, especially on higher viscosity liquids. And basically the way that works is as the motor turns the shaft, it turns both rotors, it pulls the liquid into the suction side, captures it between the wings, and pushes it out the other side. You've got no slip paths or very long slip paths around the wings, so you don't get product ingress around the side of it. You don't break down the polymer chains, and everything goes through very, very smoothly. You can run these pumps dry because the internal rotating surfaces do not contact the body or the end cover. And we can use double mechanical seals with a seal flush to keep the seal faces clean.